Ms. Nicole McDermott, Ms. Catherine Winder, Superintendent Dr. Martin Bates, administration, faculty, staff, parents, and graduates, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Kearns High Class of 2020. The KHS Madrigals will be singing Like a River in My Soul. Next up, a word from our valedictorian, Koi Deng Nguyen.
Hello, everyone. I know these times can be hard, but I hope you and the people around you are thriving. For those who have supported the class of 2020, I wish to give you my appreciation, but it's not only my appreciation, but the class of 2020's appreciation. We thank the families, the teachers, the coaches, the administration, the counselors, the janitors, and all other professionals and relatives who have helped support and pave the way for our class of 2020. Then I want to thank my own smaller personal network, my family, my friends, my clubs, and my programs for being there for me and allowing me to be there for them. And when I look back at what I'm grateful for, I realize how important forging and maintaining relationship truly is, especially this year. The last few months have been a bit of a challenge for me, and I'm sure it was for all of you. But I hope these very relationships have helped you pull through, as they did for me. We have a plethora of relationships, ranging from strangers to mentors. They're constantly growing, changing, and yes, at times lost. While I reflect on my relationships, I implore you to reflect on yours. And to those whom you respect, whom you trust, whom you love, thank them. While thanking them may not need to be verbal, at least treat them well. While we might put some titles on relationships, such as acquaintance or stranger, they're simply titles of relationships that have yet to bloom. Nurture them with respect, and in them you may find a relationship that grows to last a lifetime. To this school, to its staff, and to all of you, the students, this has been a relationship I could ask nothing more from. And I'm sure this is not only my sentiment, but the sentiment of the class of 2020. We, the class of 2020, will continue to grow and form meaningful relationships, because that's simply how life is. With that in mind, we should be happy to take a pause to help those around us, because forming relationships is not a pause in our path, but a step forward instead. As a team, as a community, as a group, even if there are struggles, you give life a greater meaning. Hold yourself with pride, and hold others close with love. And remember, once a cougar, always a cougar.
Next up, a word from our salutatorian, Ethan Michael Cox.
Hello. My friends, we are living in unprecedented times, unimaginable only a few months ago, participating in a unique graduation. I can hardly represent an entire graduating class, but I think I speak for all of us when I say that none of us wanted our senior year, the apex not just of our high school experiences, but of our maturity from infancy to adulthood, to end like this. Perhaps we won't leave high school with the memories of senior year that we always dreamed of, but we are forming memories nonetheless. Memories of coming together during a global pandemic in a united cause. Memories of having to create innovative solutions to unprecedented problems. Memories of finding new ways to connect when face-to-face communication is no longer possible. And those memories aren't for nothing, because from this moment on, every time we ask someone when someone graduated and they say 2020, well, no, there is no class more united than ours. In the wise words of Robert Frost, two roads diverge in a wood, and I took the road less traveled by. Class of 2020, we are now confronted with a choice. We can choose to look back on this year with disappointment, to feel like it's all been ruined, and to carry that bitterness with us for the rest of our lives. Or we can choose to be grateful for all the years leading up to this point, the friendships, the hardships and pains, the successes and the failures, which have shaped who we are and who we will become. It has been said the journey is more important than the destination. I believe this is true, for it is in the journey that we learn the most important lessons, lessons that change the ways we interact with and react to the world. It is in the journey that we form the most precious relationships, relationships where we have the most potential to influence and impact the lives of others. It is in the journey that we discover who we are and choose how we define our lives. My friends, there is so much power in a definition. the way in which you characterize your life, no matter the reality of your position, will be reflected in your actions, your relationships, and your successes. We can't control every circumstance, but we can control our stance. My fellow classmates, we are only now launching into the prime of our lives. Our journey isn't over yet. In fact, it is just beginning. So take a moment to rest. Take a moment to look back, and take a moment to celebrate. Celebrate your graduation, yes. But also, celebrate the journey that got you here. And then, get up, pick up your bags, and get moving. Our adventure awaits. Thank you.
Next, Ms. Nicole McDermott.
Hello, Kearns graduates. I am so excited to be able to be with you today, even if it is virtually. I know that most of you don't know who I am, but I want you to know that I know who you are. I have seen you on stages, sports fields, and in the halls of your school. I rejoice with you in your successes, and I have mourned with you over your losses. I want you to know that the Granite School Board feels your heartbreak for what you have lost these last 2 months. We know what you have missed and feel your sadness, but we also know what incredible individuals are graduating today. You are resilient and you are strong. You have the capacity to make the best out of any situation, and we have seen you do this time and again. My remarks today center on how we can find our own happiness, especially in difficult times such as these. Have you ever found yourself saying, if I can just do fill in the blank, whatever you think, then I will be happy? Maybe for some of you that blank was graduating high school. Does this mean you are now happy and that you will be for the rest of your life? How do we achieve that true happiness? I had a friend who would say this all the time. And as I watched him check things off of his list, he didn't seem to be any happier. Why? Sean Aker, who is the CEO of Good Think Incorporated, talks about happiness, the happiest advantage, and says that it is not reality that shapes us, but the lens through which your brain views the world that shapes your reality. And if we can change the lens, we can change your happiness. Let me say that again. It is not reality that shapes us, but the lens through which your brain views the world that shapes your reality. So many people think that our external world is predictive of our happiness. But that is only true 10% of the time. 90% of the time, your happiness is not predicted by your world, but by the way your brain processes it. If we change our formula for happiness, we can change the way we affect our reality. The way society has taught us to find happiness is that it lies at the other side of success. The problem is that we create a moving target on what defines success, which means that happiness is often out of reach. Because once you have achieved one success, there's a new goal beyond that one. Once you have good grades, you want to get better grades. Once you've graduated high school, you now want to graduate from college or a trade school. So after that, it will be to find the goal of to find a job, to get married, have kids, find a better job, find a better house, find another better job, retire, travel the world, live to be 100, etc., etc. Do you see how we create a moving target for happiness? The other problem happens when our lives take a turn that we weren't expecting, and the target is completely removed from us. Did any of us expect what is happening today? How has this affected people's goals? The key is to reverse the formula for happiness. Social scientists find that when you reverse your formula and find happiness first, you are more productive, your IQ goes up, you are more creative, and you have more energy, all of which can contribute to your success. So how do we reverse this formula and find happiness now in our lives? Most experts agree that there are some fundamental principles to finding happiness. I'm going to challenge each of you and myself to take the time to do 3 of these things each day for a month so that they become a habit. So your first challenge. Some of you parents and grandparents out there might remember watching Oprah Winfrey, and from years ago, she had a gratitude journal. Her goal was to write down 5 things she was grateful for every day, and she challenged her viewers to do the same. As the years went by, her faithfulness in writing slacked off, and she found herself reviewing one of her earliest entries that spoke about some of the most simple but happiest parts of her day. In her words, she said, "When I came across that journal entry, I wondered why I no longer felt the joy of simple moments. Since 1996, I've accumulated more wealth, more responsibility, more possessions. Everything, it seemed, had grown exponentially, except my happiness. How had I, with all my options and opportunities, become one of those people who never had time to feel delight? I was stretched in so many directions. I wasn't feeling much of anything, too busy doing. But the truth is, I was busy in 1996, too. I just made gratitude a daily priority. I went through the day looking for things to be grateful for, and something always showed up. So my challenge to you is to find those gratitudes and write them down. If you can't find five things, then find three. If you can't find three, then find one. But I promise you that as you look for those moments and recognize them, you will find them more often in your life. The second challenge. We all know the power of meditation and exercise. Rigorous exercise releases endorphins, which is a hormone that relieves pain or stress and boosts happiness. Low-impact exercise releases serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter that has effects on mood, sleep, anxiety, and appetite, among other things. So even if it's going for a walk around the neighborhood, get out and exercise. Or meditate. It's a good way to clear your mind and find focus for your happiness. The third and final challenge, look outside of yourself and find ways to express your love. Arthur C. Brooks, who is an author and professor, teaches a class on happiness at Harvard Business School. In one of his books, he said, every crisis is an opportunity to love each other more. Right now, undoubtedly, we are in a crisis situation. But the way we fuel happiness is through love. The opposite to love is not hate, but fear. In a recent podcast, Mr. Brooks has recommended that we look for ways to show love. He says to say, I love you each day. It's hard for some of you to say that, I know. But when we say those words, it releases oxytocin, yet another hormone that can produce antidepressant-like effects. Most importantly, find ways to love those who you view as your enemies. Society has taught us that we have to hate people who disagree with us. That's simply not true. Mr. Brooks talked about an experience he had with the Dalai Lama. He was told by the Dalai Lama that when you love your enemies, you destroy the illusion that they were your enemies in the first place. So remember that when you hate, someone else profits by getting views, clicks, or likes. It is not worth your personal happiness. So today, as you end one journey and start on the next, please don't think that this is the happiest that you can be. But also remember that your happiness is not dependent on your success, but happiness is what you can achieve because you are capable, intelligent, caring individuals who have the capacity to feel joy. And when you seek this happiness, you will find success. I congratulate you, class of 2020, on this success in finishing not just your 12 years, but most especially this year. And I wish you all the happiness in the world because you deserve it.
Now a word from our principal, Miley Liu.
Miss Nicole McDermott, Miss Karen Winder, Superintendent Dr. Martin Bates, administration, faculty, staff, parents, graduates, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the Kearns High Class of 2020. Folks, I would like to acknowledge and thank the following staff members for their many years of service and will be retiring. Ms. Shirley Lems, Mrs. Julie Rosenloff, and Mrs. Ingrid White, thank you for your service to Kearns High. I would like to also honor our graduating seniors, and I would ask that they stand, please. Our valedictorian, Koi Dang Nguyen, please rise and stay standing. Our salutatorian, Ethan Michael Cox, please rise. Our student body president, Brianna Bartunek, please rise. And her student body officers will be there to join her. Our senior class president, Nick Lapotrello, please rise. Parents and students, this have been your leadership team this year, and I would like you to applaud them at this time. Thank you, seniors. You may be seated. I would also like to acknowledge the following groups of seniors that has contributed very well to the Kearns High scholarship total this year of $2,591,195. This is huge and unprecedented for this senior class, given the uncertainty that they have had to face over this last 2 months. That deserves a round of applause. And I would like to thank the following for their contributions: the Sterling Scholars, National Honor Society, Diploma of Merit, National Forensic and Debate, scholarship recipients, Academic All-Region, Academic All-State, our biliteracy SEAL students who have become proficient in two languages here at this school, which, by the way, has doubled this year. Very impressive. And all seniors that are leaving and entering the military, congratulations to all. Class of 2020, you have all accomplished one of the major early milestones of your lives as a high school graduate. This is a major step in the journey of your lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. This is a time of disruption and changes on our daily educational pathway, with the added stress of COVID-19 and social distancing. If you continue to remain united and disciplined, you will succeed. The pride of who you are will continue to define you and your future. This challenge we have faced is different. It is worldwide. We will meet again. You will return to a new normal setting. But for now, we do what we do for the safety of all during this graduation ceremony, which is unlike any graduating class has experienced. It is my hope that your graduation is not an end goal. It is instead a part of a longer journey. Wherever your future is meant to take you, whether a career, the military, a trade school, vocational school, technical, or college, graduates, take the leap. You deserve more. Congratulations, class of 2020. We are so proud of you. Steve Jobs says it best: don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else, seniors, is secondary. Thank you for the last 4 years of excellence and service to Kearns High. Continue to make your life count and your parents proud. Miss Nicole McDermott, I certify that 426 seniors have met and fulfilled all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Granite School District Board of Education. Miss McDermott, I present to you the class of 2020 for your acceptance. Thank you.
All right, graduates, here we go. Upon the recommendation of the principal and as a member of the Granite School Board of Education, I accept this 2020 graduating class from Kearns High School as meeting all of the state and district requirements for a high school diploma and declare them graduate. Congratulations.
Brianna Bartunek.
Bradley Gardner.
So as soon as he's gone, you can just go.
Talitha Garrison.
Holly Basinger.
Melipa Adams. Tony Peralta.
Nicholas Lopetrello.
When he goes, you go.
Jade Sotera.
Megan Sewer.
Gabriel Matua.
Sitlali Gardenas Ibarra.
Eleanora Felila.
Justin D. Williams.
Daniel Flores.
Cheyenne Beto.
Dakota Weaver.
Preston Ichon.
Go, go, go. Elena Gurney.
No middle name?
Brianna Carter.
Aurelio Barrios.
David Cruz.
Miriam Cisse.
Christian Chavarria Rodriguez.
Cristina Aguilar.
Austin Cabrera.
Kaya Fetzer.
Gabriel de la Espriella.
Colby Darling.
Afra Al Achima.
Alexis Atilano.
Zoe Fryer.
Braxton Clayton.
Emmanuel Anguano.
Go ahead. Allison DeMille.
Jacob Dixon.
McKay Butler.
Eleanor Baker.
Jocelyn Ambrosio.
Vanessa Poteo.
Jared Nasu.
Vincent Bodden.
As soon as he goes, you can go.
Got it.
Oyuki Garcia Rangel. enters the silver car. Colton James Drage.
Anthony Cerritos Bravo.
Okay, as soon as he goes, you can go. Okay, go ahead. Adrian Beltran.
Alex Cordova.
Sarah Colbrook. Go ahead and go. Sarah Colbrook.
Taylor.
Pablo Cárdenas. Colby Cook.
You can go ahead and walk up there.
Jordan Dolato.
Go ahead, Kaylee. Kaylee Gray.
Alejandro Garcia.
Rosa Inez Chacon.
Cody Cannon.
Mayra Gamboa.
Alicia Flores.
John Castro.
Lynette Gurola.
Kayla Black.
Shayla Gordon.
Right here. Emily Edwards.
Isaiah Afatasi.
Go ahead, Colton. Colton Brockbrader.
Congratulations. Hannah Gale.
As soon as she goes, she can go. Good job, Tiffany. No middle name, Tiffany Jones. Go ahead.
Tiffany Benson.
Jasmine Lizeth Alvarenga Cuella.
Jasmine Bankhead.
She goes, you can go. Go ahead.
Ethan Cox. Jose Flores.
Jocelyn Boone.
Taylam Gameros.
Marcia Lynn Baum.
Johnny Chow.
Aaron Garcia.
Victor Luis Cajahuanca Echevarria.
Lady Lisbeth Cajahuanca Echevarria.
Javier Barragan Rios.
When he goes, you can go, Angeline. Good job on your work. Go ahead.
Sativa Angelia Scott.
When she goes, then you can go ahead and walk up there.
Manny Sale.
Jesus Dominguez.
Nathan Todd.
Rafael Aburto.
Go ahead, Abby.
Abby Argyle.
All right. When she goes, you can go. Congratulations. You did your work for government. Good job. Fairly. Go ahead, go.
Esteban Camacho.
Vanessa Alvarez.
Eric Villaseñor.
Tanya Bada.
Jersey Essek.
That's what's taking so long as the cars are back up.
We need to keep moving those cars.
Luis De Luna.
Jesus.
Alexis Gomez Areano.
Jesus Gutierrez Rivera.
Cesar Garcia.
Lily Fouts.
Lita Gubler.
Anybody call you star?
Estrella Farias.
Isaac Chaparro.
Andrea Gutierrez. Kimberly Anderson. Mikhail Davidson.
Sadie Carroll.
Go ahead. Annalise J. Bailey. Martin Gonzalez Jr. Gavin Reese Davis. Maria Chacin.
Thank you.
Angela Edwin, llamado Edwin.
Corinne Peterson!
I see you didn't change your name. And when Corinne goes, you go, go ahead, Caleb.
Caleb Christensen.
Josué Gutierrez!
Andrew Cloward.
Isaac Garcia!
Go ahead, Camille.
Camille Anderson.
Jason Doe!
Cody Alden Gertson.
Samantha Hagen!
Abby Drown!
Manuel Gutierrez Astorga.
Go ahead, Samantha.
Samantha Brown.
Adrian Martinez.
under there, my shoes.
Yep. Grace Ann Lund.
Zaid Colin Mayo.
Zain Colon Mayo. Isabel Hernandez Jimenez.
Yeah, go ahead. Hello, Danny.
Dakota Hood.
Danny Din. Hayden Morrison. Wala Ibrahim.
Brooklyn Mitchell.
Brindy Mitchell.
Emma Helston.
Juliana Mendoza.
Brittany Ida Belais.
No middle name?
Seth Helton. Kevin Wilson. Marty Tanifa. Riley Kimball.
Danielle Mendez Hernandez.
Virginia Millard.
Kalei Hokam.
Maria Hernandez.
Thank you.
Sherilyn Jessup. Jasmine Mosqueda. Vivian Hoffman. Naya Howard.
Mikala Heron.
Caden Hill. Antonio Martinez.
Nathan Harper.
Daniela Martinez Hernandez. Brandon McCarthy. Yeah.
Montes.
Kylie Muir. Muir. Muir, Muir. Muir. Uziel Montero. Sadie Holfeld.
Isaias Lucio Charles.
Ivan Medina Lopez. Shayla Larson. Sarah Martin. Anastasia Layton.
Anthony justice.
John Heskett. Miles Carter Johnson. Zoe Hoops. Camilla Hatch.
Hello, Bella.
Eddie Bertha.
Ethan Levitt. Iosua Lamson. Taija Kwaja.
Jose de Jesus Mendoza.
Ooh, that was a good one.
He's my favorite kid.
Gilberto Martinez.
Tate Harward.
Dustin Hinojosa.
Jaylena Kumadakis.
Miley Milan. Brody Lockhart.
Jennifer Leva Galeana.
Stephanie Leva. Pena Letty. Alexia Hickman. Brandon Hernandez Luna. Pablo Martinez.
Jason Favon.
Tumema Tuagiagi. Mayeli Moreno. Songa Maina. Brandon Laws.
Kiana Hola.
Angeles Pastor Nutter. Spencer Bennett. Jordan Marie Lear.
Tatiana Mills.
Tuanga champion Matapula!
Justin Rich. Mariela Martinez. Leslie Pisana Oropesa. Brianne Rossini. Kimberly Jaimez Ortiles. Austin Perry. Congratulations.
Miss Luna Vargas.
Adrian Quiles.
Ketzlali Petroza.
Chloe Romero. Gavin Plotis. Jaden Hendricks. Henry Writing. Ashley Paddock. Katie Ortiz.
Melissa Pereira.
Lila Pierce. Dakota Lind. Jorge Navarrete.
Jason Peterson.
Camden Nielsen. Bridget Rodriguez. Jordan Osler. Dawson Rasmussen. Woo!
Elizabeth Peterson.
Daniel Rosas.
Maria Serna.
Luis Orozco.
Orozco.
Are you okay, Mr. Ashley?
Dalia Naomi Rodriguez.
Anthony Picken. Koi Win. Moises Perez Jr.
Ariana North.
Fabiana Romero. Sheila Prudente.
Oh, Mitzi Nava Ramirez.
Jorge Torres Lucero. Chase O'Brien.
Alejandro Nachampasak.
Kylie Peasley.
Jose Ramirez.
Valencia Marie Ortega. Miles Rollins. Stephanie Oakleberry.
Jessica Badia Cruz.
Oh. Desiree Reese.
Diana Valdez.
Charlotte Rigby.
Fatima Rodriguez.
Andrew Rincon. Kingston Sapoy.
Alexis Taft.
Omar Neri. Tiffany Soto. Tylee K. Walters. Damian Sepulveda. Jennifer Rosas. Jonathan Salas Rivas. Eric Sierra Garcia. Michaela Waite. Jacob Schultz. Samuel Shrewsbury. Mm-hmm.
Nilton Sandoval.
Montserrat Serna.
Stacy Solis.
Amethyst Stevens. Christian Tapia. Xavier Yakovich. Juan Zamudio.
Juan Zapata.
Hayden Turnbow.
Woo!
Brinley Shuring.
Jacqueline Taylor. Desmond Richards. Tyler Startup. Hillary Vargas. Karina Tapia. Brandy Swenson.
Thank you.
Mina Jade Smith. Frank Thomas the Third. Sarah Valencia. Dominic Sanchez. Alexia Stonehawker. Jesse Vega.
Sigrid Seymour.
Jeffrina St. Germain. Ola Williams.
Guadalupe Villalobos.
Jasmine Wall. Mario Zamora.
Yes, I won.
Marcus Rye.
Kelly Samudio.
Jesus Sanchez.
Receta Tuifua!
José Piña Reyes.
Colani Tanielu.
Now a word from Ms. Winder.
Hello, my name is Karen Winder and I am president of the Granite School Board. Congratulations to the class of 2020. It is a true honor for me to sign your diplomas, knowing that you will go down in history as a graduating class unlike any other. Your senior year didn't end the way any of us thought it would. In fact, we will be talking about this unique time for many, many years to come. Please know how proud we are of you for overcoming adversity and disappointment, for being resilient, and for working hard toward graduation. Good luck in your future endeavors, whatever they may be. And once again, congratulations to the class of 2020.
Now a word from our SBO president, Brianna Bartunek.
Hello, my name is Brianna Bartunek and I'm the 2020 student body president of Kearns High School. When I think back to the broad topic of high school, I think of it being fun, tiring, exciting, and stressful. I think of all of the assemblies, football games, dances, events, and as well as just sitting in classes. Through all of the early mornings, the late nights, the tears, the laughs, we overcame and achieved. If you haven't had the feeling of relief and comfort, it is probably hitting about now. Today we get the opportunity to celebrate the final achievement in high school. I wish I had time to recognize each of you that represented us so well. Your accomplishments have not gone unnoticed. Thanks to all the athletes who performed well in front of coaches, those who achieved Sterling Scholar, scored high on the ACT, received awards and scholarships for college, and anything else that you have accomplished. You made Kearns High proud. When it was my first day at Kearns High School 4 years ago, I was scared, nervous, and really self-conscious. I am now a senior graduating high school, and I'm still scared, nervous, and self-conscious. The difference from then and now is that now I have experience, and that experience has brought me faith, hope, and belief. There is nothing wrong with being scared, nervous, and self-conscious. In fact, without all of those emotions, I wouldn't have achieved or learned as much. Without fear, how could I be brave? If I were never nervous, I might have been less cautious. By facing my self-consciousness, I learned to be strong and confident. High school has helped teach me how to be brave, careful, strong, and confident. It's not the beginning or the end of the story that's the most valuable. It's all of the in-betweens. It's the journey. It has always been about the journey, not the destination. Sure, we don't get a proper last day of school, a last prom, a senior ball, an opportunity to compete in spring sports, a traditional graduation, but we cannot look back and let our entire senior year be ruined by this pandemic. Our journey was a little crazy, but the final chapter doesn't tell the whole story. Each of us here should be proud. Be proud that today you're graduating high school, even though some lacked faith. Be proud that we didn't give up. Be proud that even though we finished our senior year through a computer screen, other seniors around the globe did too. We are not alone. We are strong, courageous, and hopeful. And this is why we are the class that will survive COVID-19. We focused on what we could control rather than what we couldn't. We are going to be better than okay because we have made mistakes and learned from them. We have been knocked down and we got back up. We are the class of 2020. We are a generation of change, a generation of adversity, and a generation of hope. Here's to a huge milestone for all of us. This is an awesome beginning for our journey, so get up, get excited, and be proud of this accomplishment and who you are. Thank you to all of the staff, teachers, administration, and the Board of Education for preparing, enabling, believing, and leading us into a new normal. Thank you to all the family and friends for supporting and caring for the members of the class of 2020. We appreciate you. Quickly, I'd like to personally thank my SBOs, Tucson, Tony, Bradley, Holly, Melipa, and Talitha Joe for being my BFFs and serving with me this year. Thank you to my mom, stepdad, and the rest of my family and friends for supporting me. Lastly, I'd like to thank the people who helped me become student body president and the person that I am today. Thank you to Anaya May, Bob Osberg, and Tyler Garcia for helping me achieve this goal. Thank you, class of 2020, for allowing me to serve you throughout high school. You were all great, genuine people who can achieve anything you put your mind to. I am so deeply proud of all of you. Do not ever give up and remember to always be you. I think I'm supposed to end a speech with one phrase, but I've chosen two. First, it's a great day if you make it that way. And lastly, once a cougar, always a cougar. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Nicholas Lopetrello, the senior class president of 2020. I'm glad to be able to see everyone who has worked so hard for this moment, even if it's short-lived and not the scenario we thought we would have. This is a hard time that we are all currently facing, but I'm glad to be standing right here giving this speech as us seniors prepare the next big step in our lives. We are here to celebrate all those hard times both parents, family members, and the class of 2020 has all been through. I want to start off by thanking all the teachers, parents, and family who have helped raise us into the fine men and women that we are today, as well as the internet, copy and paste, and the wiki. Without all your never-ending love, support, and guidance, the only thing we know how to do is send each other videos on TikTok and pour a bowl of cereal. I don't know if I would be the one giving this speech without their help. We all make mistakes. I know that I certainly have. Nick Lopetrello's style freshman year was definitely a mistake. Trying to cram all the information I possibly can about the ACT the night before was definitely a mistake. But yet, right here, I'm still standing. I've made plenty of mistakes in my short 18 years of life so far, and have I learned from all of them? No. But 8 times out of 10, mistakes are what have helped me become the man that I am today. Mistakes are one of the world's best teachers. I say that because no matter what, you always learn something after a mistake. For example, I thought writing a speech and speaking would be easy. Well, I learned I will probably never sign up to write a speech again in the future, so as you can all see, mistakes are about learning. The class of 2020 has experienced and learned so much together, from winning region in multiple sports with those who finished top 3 in their region, to the others who qualified for state and nationals in their clubs, winning Spirit Week, surviving a pandemic, and dealing with online learning. We are not a class to fold over and give up when the going gets tough. We are a class with fight, grit, and drive like no others before. We will be remembered as the class who worked the smartest, fought for what we wanted, and partied the hardest. There's a saying, it goes, adversity breeds toughness, and toughness breeds success. Now, if that does not describe what our class has gone through, even what our community has gone through, then I don't know what does. You all know that this class of graduates will go down in history as one of the greats. You know why I know that? It is because through all the rumors talking about Kearns, with all the negative things that are said on social media and on the news, no matter what happens and what is said to us, we stand strong together, because we are not just a community, we are Kearns. Now, we all wear that name with pride as we do our own last name. Thinking back on the experiences we have had with pulling all-nighters, drinking more coffee than water, and using Quizlet and Google more than asking our parents for help, these mistakes will teach us forever-lasting lessons that we will take into our futures. I know many of us did not picture the beginning of this next chapter in our lives like this, but there's a quote I want you to all hear. You can't go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending. Let's take this time that we have been given as an opportunity to truly understand how much time in our lives is left as we look towards the future and begin to part ways. Never forget where you came from, and always remember you can change the outcome. Congratulations, class of 2020, and join me as we turn our tassel as now we take our next step into our futures. We did it.